Welcome to Max class. In this section we are discussing about Clairaut's equation. Okay, please listen. The differential equation will involve dy by dx. Okay, the differential equation must involve dy by dx in higher degree. And suppose that this dy by dx is equal to p. Okay, what is p? Suppose that p is dy by dx, then the differential equation will be of the form f of x y p equal to 0. Remember that the differential equation will involve dy by dx, and suppose that dy by dx equal to p. Remember that, what is dy by dx is denoted by the letter p. If dy by dx equal to p, then the differential equation can be of the form f of x y p equal to 0. Okay. Now we can solve some questions based on this one. First one is equation solvable for p. Equation solvable for p. First question is, solve x square equal to 1 plus p square. Okay. Case first is equation solvable for p. Our first question is, solve x square equal to 1 plus p square. This x square equal to 1 plus p square can be written as p square equal to x square minus 1. Okay, what is p square? P square equal to x square minus 1. Okay, then which implies what is p? Then p equal to, then p equal to plus or minus root of x square minus 1. Okay, our given question is x square equal to 1 plus p square. Then we can write p square equal to this 1 is shifting to here, then plus 1 will become minus 1. Then p square equal to x square minus 1. Then what is p? P is equal to plus or minus root x square minus 1. That is, what is our p? P is dy by dx. We know that the value of p is dy by dx. Okay, therefore p dy by dx equal to plus or minus root x square minus 1. Then this can be written as dy equal to plus or minus root x square minus 1 into dx. Okay, dy by dx is this one, therefore we can write dy equal to plus or minus root x square minus 1 dx. Okay, then integrating on both sides, we get integral dy equal to integral plus or minus root x square minus 1 dx. What is integral dy? That is y equal to, that is plus or minus root of x square minus 1. When integrating, it's a standard result. Its answer is plus or minus x by 2 into root x square minus 1 minus plus log x plus root x square minus 1 plus c. This is the required solution. Okay, remember that our question is based on equation solvable for p. X square equal to 1 plus p square, then p square equal to x square minus 1, then p equal to plus or minus root x square minus 1. Then we know that what is p? P is dy by dx. Therefore, dy by dx equal to plus or minus root x square minus 1. Then dy equal to integral of dy equal to integral this one. This is a basic result. It its action is y equal to plus or minus x by 2 into root x square minus 1 minus plus log x plus root x square minus 1 plus c. That is our required solution. Please write down on your notebook. Then we can move to our next question. Our first case is equation solvable for p. Our second case is equation solvable for y. Okay, we can do our next question. Okay, our second question is based on equation solvable for y. Okay, question is solve y equal to x minus a into p minus p square. Equation solvable for y. Okay, our second question is solve y equal to x minus a into p minus p square. Okay, consider this as our equation number 1. Okay, equation number 1. Then differentiating equation number 1 with respect to x. Differentiating this equation number 1 with respect to x, we will get dy by dx equal to product of two functions. We are differentiating product of two functions. First function into x minus a into derivative of second function dp by dx plus second function into p into derivative of first function. Derivative of x minus a is 1. Therefore p into 1, that is p, okay, minus d by dx of p square, that is equal to 2p into dp by dx. Okay, this is our equation number 1. We are differentiating both sides with respect to x. Then we will get dy by dx equal to x minus a into dp by dx plus p minus 2p into dp by dx. Then what is dy by dx? That is p. P equal to x minus a into dp by dx plus p into p minus 2p into dp by dx. Here p and p cancel. Then the remaining can be written as, here dp by dx is on, here is dp by dx, here is also dp by dx. Therefore, we can take dp by dx as common. That is 0 equal to x minus a minus 2p into dp by dx. Okay. 0 equal to x minus a minus 2p into dp by dx. That is dp by dx equal to 0 by x minus a minus 2p. That is equal to 0. Therefore, we get dp by dx equal to 0. That means we know that the derivative of a constant is always 0. Here, dp by dx equal to 0, which implies that p equal to c, where c is a constant. Okay, dp by dx equal to 0, therefore we can write p equal to c, where c is a constant. Therefore, which implies from equation 1, we can write p is replaced by c. Therefore, our solution is from equation 1, y equal to x minus a into p. What is p? P is c. X minus a into c minus p square. We know that p is c, c square. This is how a required solution. Y equal to x minus a into c minus c square. Once more, our question is solve y equal to this one. First we may differentiating both sides with respect to x. Then we will get dy by dx is, we know that the value of dy by dx is p. Therefore, p equal to x minus a into dp by dx plus p minus 2p dp by p and p cancelled, remaining is 0 equal to this one. Therefore, dp by dx equal to 0. We know that the derivative of a constant is always 0. Therefore, p equal to c. Therefore, from equation 1, we can write y equal to x minus a into p, but p is replaced by c, c minus c square. This is our required solution. Please write down on your notebook. Hi students, now we are going to study about Clairaut's equation. Very very important topic, Clairaut's equation. The equation y equal to px plus f of p is known as Clairaut's equation, where p equal to dy by dx. What is Clairaut's equation? Remember that the equation y equal to px plus f of p is known as Clairaut's equation. Remember that, where p equal to dy by dx. Okay, that is Clairaut's equation, and equation of the form y equal to px plus fp is known as Clairaut's equation, where p equal to dy by dx. Now I am going to teach you how to solve Clairaut's equation. Just listen. Please write down this on your notebook, Clairaut's equation. Equation of the form y equal to px plus f of p. Okay, how to solve Clairaut's equation? Listen, we know that Clairaut's equation is y equal to px plus f of p. Suppose that this is our equation number 1. Now, differentiating both sides of equation number 1, when differentiating, we get dy by dx equal to, we are applying product rule, p into derivative of x is 1 plus x into second into derivative of first dp by dx plus f of p. When differentiating with respect to x, we get f dash p into dp by dx. Okay. Then, what is dy by dx? We know that dy by dx is p. Therefore, p equal to p plus, these two terms can be taken outside. Then, dp by dx is common. Therefore, this can be written as x plus f dash p into dp by dx. Okay, that is, here p and p cancel, then this will become x plus f dash p into dp by dx equal to 0, which implies dp by dx equal to 0. That is, here dp by dx will become 0 by x plus f dash p. Therefore, we get dp by dx equal to 0. We know that the derivative of a constant is always 0. Therefore, here p is a constant. Therefore, suppose that, which implies dp by dx equal to 0, which implies p is equal to a, where a is a constant. Putting this value in equation number 1, we get y equal to px. What is p? P is a. Therefore, this will become ax plus f of a. F of p will become this one. Therefore, y equal to ax plus f of a, which is the required solution. Okay, once more lesson. What is our Clairaut's equation? Is y equal to px plus f of p equal to 1. Differentiating equation number 1 with respect to x, we get dy by dx equal to product rule. We are applying product rule. P plus x into dp by dx plus f dash p into dp by dx. That is, we know that dy by dx is p. Therefore, p equal to p plus this one. P and p cancel, then we get x plus f dash p equal to dp by dx. That is equal to 0. Therefore, we can write, which implies dp by dx equal to 0. That means p is a constant. Then, from equation number 1, we get y equal to ax plus f of p. Okay, please write down on your notebook. Our next question is, solve p equal to log px minus y. Okay, solve p equal to log px minus y. Okay, taking exponential on both sides, we get e raised to p equal to e raised to log px minus y, which is equal to, we know that e raised to log a equal to a. Therefore, e raised to log px minus y is equal to px minus y. That is, e raised to p equal to px minus y, which implies minus y is shifting to here, then it will become y equal to px minus e raised to p. Okay, y equal to px minus e raised to p, which is our Clairaut's equation. Then we know that how to solve Clairaut's equation by putting p equal to a, where a is a constant. Then we will get y equal to px, p is replaced by a constant, that is ax minus e raised to a. Or from this equation we can write p, that is, this will become, when p equal to a constant, this equation will become a equal to log px minus a, that is p a minus y. Okay, which is the required solution. Okay, so all p equal to log px minus y, we are taking exponential on both sides, then we get e raised to p equal to px minus y, at least e raised to p equal to px minus y. Therefore, y equal to px minus e raised to p, at least we know that this is a Clairaut's equation. Then we can substitute p equal to a, p is a constant, therefore it will become y equal to ax minus e raised to a, that is a equal to log pa minus y. This is our required solution. Okay. Okay, now we can move to your next question. Please write down on your notebook. And our next question is, our next question is, solve y minus px into p minus 1 into p minus 1 equal to p. Solve y minus px into p minus 1 equal to p. Then this equation can be written as y minus px equal to, this p minus 1 is shifting to here, then it will become p by p minus 1. That is, y equal to px by p minus 1. Okay. Y equal to px, or this px can be written as xp. You know that a into b is equal to b into a. Therefore, y equal to xp plus p by p minus 1. Okay. Differentiating both sides with respect to x, this equation will become dy by dx equal to, we are applying product rule, first function x into, differentiate with respect to x, that is dp by dx, plus second function is p into, derivative of x is 1, plus differentiate p by p minus 1, then denominator into p minus 1 into derivative of the numerator dp by dx minus numerator into derivative of the denominator the whole divided by denominator square. Okay. Then what is dy by dx? We know that dy by dx is p. Therefore, this will become p equal to x into dp by dx plus p into this one. Then we can cancel p from here. Here is a p, here is a p. Therefore, that is 0 equal to we can write down x into dp by dx. Then we can take dp by dx as common. Therefore, the remaining is plus p minus 1 minus p into dp by dx, the whole divided by p minus 1 square. Here p and p cancel, the remaining is minus 1. That is, this will become here is x dp by dx minus, here is minus 1 by p minus 1 square into dp by dx equal to 0. Okay, that is dp by dx can be taken outside, then the remaining is x minus 1 by p minus 1 square into dp by dx equal to 0. Okay. That means dp by dx equal to 0 by x minus 1 by p minus 1 square. That is, which implies dp by dx equal to 0. dp by dx equal to 0 means we can write, when dp by dx equal to 0, then we can write p equal to a, where a is a constant. Okay, remember that we get dp by dx equal to 0. That means p equal to a. P is a constant. Then from equation number first, we can write what is our equation number first? Y minus Px into P minus 1 equal to P. That is our equation number 1. That is, we know that P equal to A. P is a constant. Therefore, this equation will become Y minus Ax into P minus 1. A minus 1 equal to A. This is our required solution. Okay. We are finding out dp by dx, that is equal to 0. We know that derivative of a constant is 0. Therefore, p equal to a is a constant. Then we are substituting the value of p equal to a on our first equation. First equation is y minus px into p minus 1 equal to p. That is y minus ax into a minus 1 equal to 0 equal to a. This is our required solution. Please write down on your notebook. Very, very important Clairaut's equation. These are problems based on Clairaut's equation. Thank you for watching. For more educational videos, please subscribe our channel. If you have any doubt, then please write down on the comment box below. Okay, thank you.